the torque on a current carrying loop. So here we have a current carrying loop, and case one is when the plane of the loop is perpendicular to the magnetic field. So here the direction of the magnetic field is that way, and the plane is exactly plane is PQRS. It is perpendicular to that. And now let us find the forces on each. So length of this PQ and SR, they are B, and the length of PS and QR, they are L, as shown in the figure. Now I am finding the force experienced by each of the segment, because PQ, QR, RS and SP, all of them can be treated as a straight wires, right? They are like part of the straight wire. So I am treating like PQ. Let us say the direction of current is this way. Okay. So I am taking this as the direction of the current. And now let us find the forces. So first PQ, it is coming out of the plane and the magnetic field is that way, right? So I am keeping my palm that way so I can turn it. So force is coming to be dl cross r upward. So here the force is upward. How much it is? It is ILB. So current is, let's say, I. The length is basically small b, that's L, okay? And capital B is the magnitude of magnetic field. Now force on this part, SR, that is again L cross B. So B is that way, so it is downward. So force is downward. And what is the magnitude? It is again ILB. So force is I. The length of the section is B, and the capital B is the magnitude of magnetic field. So these two forces are equal, they are opposite. And now let us discuss, and they are acting exactly in the middle of these wires. Now, force on this QR part, do L cross B. So L is downward, B is that way. So L, so I'm like L is downward, B is this way. So if you see, it is this way, right? So out of the screen. So on this, it is out of the screen like that. And it is force is nothing but I, the length, which is L, and B, ILB. For on this part, the direction of current is other way around. So L cross B, it is into the plane of the paper, and it is same ILB. Length is L for this section, PS as well. So ILB. If you see, there are four forces, and all of them are cancelling out each other, right? This one is being cancelled out by that, and this one is being cancelled out by this. So we can say the total force is basically zero. Remember, we discussed the force on a bent wire. It is I into effective length into B, right? So for a closed loop, whether it is a square shape, a rectangular shape or an irregular shape, the L effective is going to be zero. And hence, we'll always get the net force as zero only. So on a closed loop, the net force on a inside a magnetic field is always and always zero. Okay, so we will say that sum of all the forces is basically zero. What about the torque? We are going to discuss the torque. So when we saw that diagram, we had understood that there were equal and opposite forces over here. I am calling them as F1. And there are equal and opposite forces over here. I am calling both of them as F2. They were different, right? The length was L and B. So they were different. So I am saying these two forces, the plane is perpendicular, they are acting up and down, and the plane is like this. So on the, there is no difference between their line of action. They are forming a couple. These two F1, they are forming a couple, but the perpendicular distance between their line of action, they are acting along the same line of action. So they are not producing any torque at all. Similarly, these two F2, they are also acting along the same line of action. They are also a couple, and they are also not producing any torque at all. So we can say, since the line of action of the forces on these are same, so they are not producing any torque at all. Now, next case is when the plane of the loop is inclined at some angle, okay, so from the magnetic field. In such case, again, the same amount of force is going to act. This will be upward. I'm calling that F1. This will be downward. I'm calling that F2. Sorry, F1. Just equal and opposite. This is my F2 and this is again F2. Here also sum of all the forces is going to be zero. But torque, is that zero? Answer is a no. So sum of all the forces is zero. But if you see that figure, okay, so I'm making another figure that I'm looking from this direction. So the P and Q will be same point for you. Right, P and Q, and the wire will, the entire plane will look like a wire, right, which is slightly tilted. So I am making you this view. So this is like my PQ and this is like my RS or SR, right? Both the points will be at this point. Now, I'm not discussing forces on these two. Forces on QR and PS, they were equal and opposite and their line of action was same, right? It is slightly tilted like this. So line of action is same, but here the line of action, the force was upward. Here my force, this was, how much force it was? This force was ILB and length was small b. So this force was IB capital B. And equal amount of force was acting in the downward direction on SR. So that is again I small b capital B. Now if you see these two forces, they are a couple. But there is some distance between their line of action, right? So how much is this length? This length is basically QR or PS, right? That's nothing but L. Let us say that it is making an angle theta, okay? The plane of the loop, that plane of the loop is taken in which direction? So if this is like, current is flowing like this, you turn your right hand, take your right hand, curl your finger around the loop, okay? And then you see the thumb is inside. So that is area vector. Area vector is perpendicular to the plane of the area. And the curl finger, the direction of current tells you the whether it is into the plane of the paper, a plane of the loop or out of the plane of the loop. And hence it is going to be, this is my area vector. So area vector is a vector, area is a vector quantity. We'll discuss this later. So angle it is making from B vector was that way, is theta. Now if this is L, this is theta. So this is 90 degree because this is the plane of the loop. So this is 90 degree, this is 90 minus theta, this is 90, so this is theta again. So if you see, this is L, so this one is going to be L cos theta, and the perpendicular distance between these two forces which are forming a couple, the line of action, the distance between their line of action is this, which is L sin theta. How do we write the torque of a couple? So we will say that torque of a couple is nothing but any one force which was I, B, capital B into distance between their line of action which was L sin theta. This is my torque. And if you see this expression, the I, the small b and L, B and sin theta. So what is B into L? If you check, the B into L is the area, right? So the area vector, this is basically I and this is area, I, A, B, sin theta. So A, B, sin theta means there must be A cross B or B cross A. So we just need to check the direction, right? Here, due to this force and this force, what will happen due to this force and this force? It is going to turn like that. So eventually it will turn like that due to these two force. So that's the torque, and torque is I, A, B, sin theta for this single loop, right? Here, what will happen if there are n number of turns? So, if there are n number of turns like this, then torque will simply become n times, because each part of each of those wire will experience a force here also, each of. So, simply it will become n times. So, it is IAB sin theta, then becomes NIAB sin theta. And if you want to write the vector form, then we can also write that torque is nothing but M cross B. What is M? So, M is known as magnetic moment of the loop. And what is M? If you see M cross B, so it is a cross product, so sign is also gone, and this is basically M is nothing but NIA. So it is NIA vector cross B. Now A vector cross B vector covers AB sin theta. So N, that is AB sin theta, that's A cross B, and this is NI, right? So this is torque is given by M cross B. What is M? M is NIA, and then it is known as magnetic moment of the loop. Why are we talking about magnetic moment? So like there is basically electric dipole. We have discussed the dipole, right? So dipole, electric dipole has a magnetic dipole moment, right? Similarly, a magnetic dipole, so a current carrying loop behaves as a magnetic dipole, and it has a magnetic moment, or you can call it magnetic dipole moment, which is written as capital M vector, and it is given by NIA. What is N? N is the number of turn in the loop, I is the current flowing in the loop, and A vector is the area vector. The direction of area vector we already discussed, Just curl your finger along the current. If the current is flowing clockwise, then it is into the plane of the paper. If current is flowing anti-clockwise, then it is out of the plane of the paper or plane of the loop. So that's what the magnetic moment is. Now we are just going to discuss it in detail. So current carrying loop as magnetic dipole. So remember we discussed the magnetic field due to a ring. So now this is a ring which is carrying some current. Ring is also a loop, right? So if ring is carrying some I current, then its magnetic moment will be I into it. I haven't included the N because the number of turns I have taken as 1. Because I am just talking about a single ring. So number of turns is 1. So N is 1. So I into A. And what is area? Area is basically pi r square. And here we are saying A cap. A cap just represent the direction. It is basically this direction is the. So it is the I pi r square is the magnetic moment. And direction is towards positive x axis in this case. Now we found that at very large distance, x way way greater than r. We discussed this, right? So the magnetic field comes to be. So magnetic field at x on the axis at a distance x was given by mu naught I r square divided by 2 r square plus x square raised to power 3 by 2. And if x is way way greater than r, here we can neglect this r. And eventually we'll get this expression, right? Check it out, mu naught I r square upon 2, and this will become x square raised to power 3 by 2 x cube, right? So this is the expression which we get if x is way way greater than r. And this expression is basically similar to, so this expression I am converting into this, which is similar to that. What does that signify? I'll be telling 1 second. So here what I am going to do is I am multiplying by 2 pi, and here also I am multiplying with 2 pi. This becomes 2 into 2 pi is 4 pi. This is x cube, right? This 2 is going in the front. So this is this 2. And then mu naught. And this is like I into pi r square. So mu naught into I into pi r square. Here, what does each thing represent? So here, this is 2 mu naught upon 4 pi. I into pi r square, which is I into pi r square, is nothing but m vector. Now, this is the magnetic field due to a ring, which is a magnetic pole or magnetic dipole. So, due to a magnetic dipole, field is given by this expression, which is similar to that expression. What is that expression? That is electric field due to an electric dipole on its axis. So, which is 2kp by r cube. Remember this expression, 2kp by r cube. So, our k is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, p is magnetic electric dipole. R cube is like x cube. We are talking about at x distance on the axis, and 2 is this. Here also it is same. It's just 2 is 2. Instead of k, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught, we use mu naught upon 4 pi, which we are using in magnetism. Instead of electric dipole, we use a magnetic dipole. And x cube is x cube. So they are identical. So we can say a current carrying loop exactly behaves as a electric dipole. Like electric dipole produces electric field on its axis, magnetic dipole produces magnetic field on its axis, and the expression for both of them are identical. There is just one small condition that this r should be small and the x should be very big. So basically a ring behaves as a magnetic dipole for larger distances, we can say like that. There is a question which we are going to discuss. This question says the rectangular coil having 100 turns in a uniform magnetic field as shown in the figure. Now, this is the coil. It is having 100 turns and carrying some current. And there is a uniform magnetic field. Now, the torque acting on the loop is. So, torque is how much? We discussed it is NIAB sine theta. We just need to write the value. So, number of turns is nothing but there are 100 turns, it is mentioned over here. Current, the current is mentioned in the figure. As you can see, current is 0.5 ampere. A is the area of it. So, area is 0.04 meter is, and this is 0.08. And we just multiply these two. So, it is going to be 4 by 100 into 8 by 100. So, that is 32 by 10 raised to power 4. That's area. And then, magnetic field. Magnetic field is mentioned in the figure. No, let's just take magnetic field as 1 Tesla. So, I'll be saying into the plane of the paper. I'm taking magnetic field into this direction, which is 1. So, magnetic field is 1 Tesla in this direction. So, I'll be saying the value is 1 Tesla and sine theta, angle between area vector and B vector. If you see, area vector is towards X and the B vector is towards Y. So, angle is 90 degree there. So, I'm writing sine 90, which is 1. And now, this is 1. Now, simply solve it. This is gone. So, 1 is gone over here and it is just 32 into 5, which is 160 and 00 and 10 raised to power 4. And 3 zeros are cancelled and you get 1.6 Newton meter. Everything is SI. So, the answer is 1.6 Newton meter. That's my thought on the this loop having 100 turns, carrying a current of 0.5 ampere and having an area of 0.0032 meter square.